Welcome. Okay, we're in downtown San Diego. I've lived here for a year. This is my studio, loft, apartment in downtown. It's pretty cool. I work here, sleep here, and sometimes I exhibit here. This type of painting I've done for the past 12 years. These are on stone. I break the stone, I see an image, and I start painting. I started that with Hearts of Stone, a company I started and built. It started with making the hearts and evolved into doing other images on stone. Interested in me doing the stones right now, though? This is my love, and this is more folk art, and they've taken awards and honors and been in museums, actually. This type of style has made it to the National Catholic Museum of Art and History in New York. Was on an exhibit in Washington, D.C. at the Historical Society of the Contemporary Frescoes. Again, a broken stone. See the image after the stone is broken, and then I paint. And the paint is up to 10 layers, 12 layers of paint, and sealants in between each one. I was ill and was in bed, and I was trying to figure out what Jackson Pollock did. I actually didn't like Jackson Pollock, and I could not figure out what it was he was trying to portray. So while I was recovering, I decided I would try his style. These were my closet doors. There's three of them. It's a triptych. And the first time, my first start, I actually did it while they were still on the walls in my bedroom, and the first stroke went up onto the ceiling and onto the floor and onto my bedspread, and I immediately took these 75-pound doors outside and laid them in the grass and spent a week trying to figure out what it was that Pollock was doing. As I said, I wasn't really crazy about Pollock's work, and within a day, I was hooked. I was incredibly hooked. It's difficult. It's not what I thought. It's not throwing paint on. There's a number of times that I've actually erased whole images. I don't know why. I mean, I don't know what I see. It's not a conscious level trying to lay the painting out. It's something that happens subconsciously, and it's right or it's not right. Again, I picked up something on Pollock. I happen to like his blue poles because it divided the images and, I don't know, it gave me a starting point. It gave me a focal point to have a division and not just total chaos. So I started, I call them trees, and it's just sort of an abstract image of trees, but it gave me that division, and from there I could work all of the chaos around it. To me, it's almost like the molecular structure of things. The movement that I feel with trees and life and anything. I mean, everything has molecules that are moving at all times, albeit sometimes very slowly. Do you like how I threw that away? These are very abstract, though I call them trees, as I said. On these, I have a consultant in New York that asked me if I could transfer this into landscapes, and I've been working on a body of landscape work for the last, I don't know, 9 months here in the studio, and I can show you a couple of those and show you how I process it. This was my largest piece, or this still is my largest piece so far. This is a beach scene. There's a, I call it beach grass. It has the grass growing on the shoreline with the sand and then the ocean and the sky above, and I just had a ball doing this. I'm so glad I had this space to be able to lay something out and really start painting. It turns out it's much easier for me to do a large painting in this style than it is the smaller, tighter paintings. It's hard to get that kind of control on the small, and it is controlled. It is, you know, somewhat controlled. I don't know, I like to think of it as life. You know, you only have so much control, and the rest is where the brush throws it.
Like a leaf clings to a tree, oh my darling, cling to me. For we're creatures of the wind. whispering to me. Like a leaf clings to